To understand why the GPU is such an interesting processor today, we'll start with technology trends, why the world has gone parallel. And first, we'll start with some good news. Modern processors are made from transistors, and each year, those transistors get smaller and smaller. This graph is from Stanford's CPUDB project. Thanks, guys. What it shows is the feature size of processors over time, where the feature size is the minimum size of a transistor or wire on a chip. So what we're seeing is, this is time going in this direction, so that's a long time ago, and that's today. And this is the feature size, so how big transistors are. And notice that it's getting smaller and smaller every generation. So when you hear talk about a 45 nanometer process or 22 nanometer, that's what we're referring to, the feature size. So we see that it's consistently going down over time. As the feature size decreases, transistors get smaller, run faster, use less power, and we can put more of them on a chip. And the consequence is that we have more and more resources for computation every single year. However, we've also got some bad news. Historically, as transistors improved, processor designers would then increase the clock rates of processors, running them faster and faster every year. Let's take a look at this diagram of clock speeds over the years. So again, we have time going on this axis. Okay, so long time ago, today. And here we have clock frequency, how fast we're clocking these transistors. Historically, one of the primary drivers of clock performance has been clock speed increases. So we see over many years, we see clock speeds continue to go up. However, over the last decade, we see that clock speeds have essentially remained constant.